तो शैल वी स्टार्ट? हेलो, हेलो, इज इट ऑडिबल टू यू? Okay, so I welcome back to the last session of this 5-day online FDP in the title Deep Neural Networks and Expert System, organized by PSR Engineering College, Sivakasi. So today, this last session is about hand calculation and MATLAB implementation of two popular bio-inspired optimization algorithm. That is genetic algorithm and particle swarm optimization. So in the morning presentation, I explained you the idea behind the genetic algorithm as well as particle swarm optimization, and the inspiration behind the genetic algorithm and the particle swarm optimization, and the various steps involved in particle swarm optimization as well as the genetic algorithm. So here now I want to give you some hand calculation that I had done during my master degree course, as well as the code that is developed by me during the during my master course. So later, the same code can be extended with a variety of algorithms, flavors, that is different kinds of GA and different versions of PSO. And it has been used in variety of applications with respect to network security, data mining, as well as image processing. So that is the application side that I used this algorithm so far in my research. However, this session is just to give you a glimpse of idea about how the numbers that are involved in GA and PSO are modified with the help of the operation, and how the code for GA and PSO is implemented in the MATLAB software. So while you following this presentation, now you will clear about morning also one participant asked the question, sir, velocity and position. Now you will clear with what is velocity and what is position with respect to PSO, as well as what is gene, what is chromosome with respect to genetic algorithm. Participant, please remember that this is a computer algorithm. Computer will accept only 0 and 1 and numerical values only. So whenever I say gene, it is not actual gene, right? Likewise, whenever say velocity and position, it is not the velocity and the position of the object moving. Instead, it is a term inspired from the natural concept, and it is used in the mathematical calculation for performing the optimization process with the help of the idea generated through the algorithm of genetic algorithm as well as the algorithm of particle swarm optimization. So let me go into the slide. So to understand the operation, let me take one case study to understand the binary coded version of GA. What is the function that is taken is f of x or f of x comma y. So two variable is the response variable, x square plus y minus 11 whole square plus x plus y square minus 7 whole square, subject to x in the range 2 to 5 and y in the range 6 to 9. Participant, first please understand what the problem is. An objective function is given. Why it is said as objective function instead of normal mathematical function? Because the function is associated with the term minimize. So if you see this term with the respect to a function, then it is said as objective function. And with respect to GA and PSO, this function is said as fitness function. So how many variables are there in that function? Two variables, x and y are two variables. And its relation is expressed in terms of function f of x comma y. And what is the objective of this particular problem? We need to solve this f of x comma y by assigning the value of x and y from the range given, and then you have to find the value of f of x comma y. And this f of x comma y value should be a minimum value. That's the idea. So from x, how many possible values you can take? You can take the value 2 to 5. Likewise, from for y, the value 6 to 9. So from 2 to 5 means it is not 2, 3, 4, 5. It is not only 4 values. It is enormous value. 2.001, 2.001, 2.01. Like that, you can have to take any small meager value as a value subject to this constraint. That is, this constraint is called range constraint, or otherwise called by boundary constraint. So you have to pick a suitable value for x as well as a suitable value for y, and the selected suitable combination of x and y, if you substitute in the given function, then the f of xy should be a minimum function. So that is the problem of optimization. You also say that this problem is a searching problem. Why it is searching problem? Because you are searching for a suitable value for x and y so that f of x is minimized. So it is also called by the name searching problem. Let me go into the step. So what is the first step of genetic algorithm? That is problem representation. If you remember the morning presentation, problem representation. But clearly here, given that it is binary coded GA, that is representation strategy, that is given clearly as binary coded GA. So the representation should be of binary numbers for the variables X and Y. So the next step is problem, that is population initialization. So what is taken is, the population size is taken as 20. So remember, participant population, it is not the human population, right? So human population is in terms of Darwin's evolution theory. Now numerical population is in terms of genetic algorithm, right? So population size, how much it is taken? It is 20 population size it is taken. And for each variable, x1, x2. So here it is treated as x1 is one gene and x2 is another gene. Put together, it is stated as chromosome. So for x1, how many number of binary bits it is assigned? 10 binary bits. And for x2, it is assigned 10 binary bits. So totally, how many binary bits it is assigned? 20 binary bits. This is 20 binary bits put together is form one chromosome. So totally, how many number of population? 20 population. That means chromosome 1 up to 20. 20 chromosomes are there in the population. And how many genes are there in the each chromosome? Two genes, x1 and x2. They are represented by the number G1 to G10 for X1 and G11 to G20 for X2. So this is the population. Remember, participant, we are going to work with numbers. If I say initiate the population, it is not the human population. It is a numerical population. Since the number that is used for such BGA is a binary number, so the binary number is representation is used here. So this is the initial population. So what is the idea here? For X1, how many chromosome we have? 20 chromosome we have. For X2, how many chromosome we have? 20 chromosome we have. So we do not know exactly what value to pick for X1 from the range 2 to 5. And for X2, that means Y. So X2 here refers to Y. And for Y, we do not need what to take the value of 6 to 9. So we are randomly generating the value. So how many number of possible values we are generating? 20 possible values from we are generating. From the 20 possible values, we are going to find one possible value that best suits the problem. Remember, participant, in the morning class, the first slide, I have given one example. That is, a person is walking along the road. At one point, he is having 5 different paths. He has to choose one path. Likewise, we have 20 different value for X1 as well as for 20 different value for X2. So that is means Y. So you have to choose one possible value for X1 and another possible value for X2. And if you substitute these two value into the function, then the function should give you a minimum possible value. So likewise, take the case of a coffee example, T maximum T equal to M plus S plus C. M is in the range 25 ml to 100 ml. C is in the range, the sugar is in the range 1 by 4 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon, 1 by 4 teaspoon to 3 by 4 teaspoon for coffee powder. So you are going to take a particular portion within the range, but we do not know what range will give you a good taste. So likewise, we are generating randomly And from that, we are evaluating some 20 individuals and finally getting out the possible value there. So that is the idea here. So the next step, I think the board can be erased. Yes, thank you. So please do not do anything on the board. So fitness function. So once the values are, once the chromosomes are generated like this, then what you have to do is you have to decode the binary number representation to real number representation. So for each 10-digit binary number is changed into its corresponding decimal number by following the linear mapping rule. I am not here to discuss about the linear mapping rule. You just assume that these binary chromosome values are changed into integer value, and then that integer value is substituted in the function. Once you substituted the function, then you got the fitness value for each and every individual. That is f of x value for the first chromosome, second chromosome, third chromosome, until up to 20 chromosome. So how much value we got? The maximum value, 784 is the maximum value. 0.6134 is the minimum value, and the average fitness value is 54. So likewise, you need to calculate for every chromosome this manner. Next, after fitness calculation, then what you do is elitism operation. So elitism operation here, you have to check whether you reached the convergence or not. That is 784 is the your 0.6134 is the your maximum value. No. So you see here, the fitness function is treated in such a way that the reciprocal of the given f of x function is taken. So this k value 1000 is used as an amplification beta so that you get the value like this. Otherwise, you will get the values 0.000, 0.000, 0.000. You cannot decode the value. So that's why it is reciprocal to the value of k by 1000. So what is now what you have to take, since the given function is minimization function, and you have taken the fitness value calculation as a reciprocal of that, you have to look for the maximum value. So what is the maximum value here? 784 is the maximum value. Here, after this sphincter function evaluation step, you have to check whether you reached the optimal state or not. That means whether 784 is convincing to you or not. If you are convinced, you have to stop the process. Otherwise, you have to use the genetic operation. So what are the genetic operations? There are four different kind of operations, and they are named according to the evolutionary theory. So one is elitism. What is elitism? Keeping the best two individual. So 784 is treated as the first best because it is giving the maximum value. And 31 is the second best, which is giving the second maximum value. Likewise, the second operation is tournament selection. In tournament selection, what is done is, here only the principle of survival of the fittest is clearly imitated. That is, the individual, that is the chromosome, which is giving best value is giving more opportunities, and the individual which is giving less opportunities is deleted. Say, for example, look at the string which is giving 784 as the optimal value in the first iteration. It is giving, it is having three opportunities, seven here, seven here, seven here. That means in this place, seven is retained, whereas in this place, that string eight may be have some lower fitness value, so it may be deleted, and in that place, one more copy of the string value seven is replaced. So, likewise, you need to do for all the other cases with respect to selection operation. So then crossover operation. So what is crossover operation? It is the recombination operation in which you have to choose two parents randomly, and you have to cross swap. You have to swap the individuals of two parents so that two strings are produced. Look at the example. Two parent. This is 120 chromosome length parent. Another 20 chromosome length parent. You have to decide at which point you are going to exchange the value of two chromosome between the point 1 and 18 is exchanged. See, the upper parent 1 value is coming here and the parent 2 value is going up there. So it is nothing but the crossover operation with respect to XY chromosome. X joined with Y, male child, and X and joined with X, then female. Like that of operation here, it is performed by fusing the value of parent 1 with the parent 2, and two offspring can be produced. They are child 1 and child 2. Like this operation, you need to do it for all the rest of the parents available in the initial population. So this kind of operation is called as two-point crossover. And if you look at the literature, you can find enormous number of crossover operator. Then come to the mutation operation. Mutation operation, you know, biologically, how the mutation operation is defined, it is the sudden change in the individual. Look at the initial population. I have selected few initial population. So from this, I have to randomly pick one population, one individual, that is zero here, zero here, one, zero, one. For this randomly chosen individual, what I have to do is just I have to flip the value. That is one is converted into zero here. See, look at the last matrix population after mutation, zero here. Likewise, this zero is converted into one here. Here, this one is there. This one is converted into zero here. How it is done? It is done with the help of some kind of mask generated and with the help of the XR operation between the initial operation and the mask, the muted population is created. So likewise, this mutation operation is also conducted with respect to n individuals. So for simplicity here, three individuals are shown, but it has to be conducted with n individuals. So remember, participant, for GA, you have to take elitism operation, which is nothing but just keeping the best two copies separately. Selection operation, it is nothing but omitting the individual which is giving poor fitness value by replacing the fitness of the individual which is having more value. Third one is crossover, just swapping the values between the individual. And fourth one is mutation, just making the value of one to another in a sudden form, in like that of the biological process. So these three processes carried out. These three processes is carried out. And if you could see that, so this is the population after elitism, crossover, mutation, selection operation. Then you could find a difference that previously 784 is the maximum value. Now it is seen that 808 is the maximum value. So it means that it one iteration, there is a little improvement in the fitness value. Likewise, if you do the process repeatedly for about 50 times or for about 100 times or even for about 500 or 1000 times, definitely you will be seeing that your fitness value is getting improved for a while. But at one point of time, you could notice that there is no improvement in the fitness value and the fitness value gets saturated. That is the point said to be a convergence point. And at that point, you have to stop the execution of algorithm and getting and produce the result. So this is the convergence graph. See, so at the zeroth iteration until seventh iteration, the fitness value is some zero. Then there is an improvement in the fitness value from seventh iteration to 10th iteration. Then from 11th iteration to something 18th iteration, some fitness value is increasing, is going. Then it is going like that. Then at around 27th iteration, the fitness value is increased. After that, it is found that there is no improvement in the best fitness value, meaning that the algorithm gets saturated and you have to take the value of X and Y at that point and you have to display the result. So the result that is given is 962 for the X value 2 and Y value 6. So this is the way you have to execute the BGA, that is binary coded algorithm. And you have to give the result for the binary coded algorithm. So now our objective is satisfied, right? Out of the range of X value, that is 2 to 5, the value chosen for X is 2. Likewise for Y, the value chosen is 6. Initially, we do not know for which value we got a minimum function value for f of x comma y. Now, after this algorithm, we got a value x and y. Then if you substitute that value x and y, definitely that value is the minimum value. So that value for f of x comma y through this binary coded GA is 962. So let me go to the next algorithm, that is a real coded GA, that is a real number representation. For which the same example is taken, x square plus y minus 11 whole square, x plus y square minus 7 whole square, subject to the condition 2 to 5 for x and 6 to 9 for y. So what is initial population? See, look at the initial population slide. There we have only binary numbers. That is a 10-digit binary numbers. So it is not necessary to go for 10-digit binary numbers. It depends on the problem and the nature of the variable. Either you can go for 3-digit binary variable or 2-digit binary variable or 5-digit or 7-digit, or even you can go for 20-digit. That is depending on your nature of the variable or the range of the input variable. Since the range of the input variable is minimum, it is taken 10 digits. Otherwise, I can reduce still further. But for real coded GA, there is no need to go for binary representation. So there is no need to worry about how many binary string I have to take. So I can directly initiate the variable with the corresponding value between the given range. So what is the range of X? X is 2 to 5. So within 2 to 5, I have generated how many possible values? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That means the population size is 10. There, the population size is 20 is taken for illustration. Here, the population size is taken as 10 for illustration. So the population size, it is depends on the problem accuracy. You can take any value starting from 10 or starting from 30. You can go up to 50 or 60. So likewise for Y also, the randomly the values are generated. What is the range of Y? It is 6 to 9. So those values are randomly generated. So after the random generation of this value, what you have to do? You have to substitute this x and y into f of x. For each x and y, you have to produce the f of xy value. So the f of xy value are this. These are the f of xy value for each of the x and y value, individual values, for which I observed that the minimum value is 0.1714 and the maximum value is 0.6047. So I have to think whether I have to stop the algorithm or I can go for operation. So when I have to stop this algorithm, if I am satisfied with the 0.604, then I treat this 0.604 as the maximum value for the given objective function. That is, since we have taken fitness value, that reciprocal of the objective value. So I have to treat that 0.6047 as the desired objective value, for which what is the corresponding x and y? What is the corresponding x and y? That is third individual, right? What is the corresponding x and y? Third individual. 4.68. 6.25 is the optimal value for x and y, for which the f of xy is 0.6047 that I have to report. In case if I feel that the algorithm is not converged and I have to go further, means the next immediate step is you have to apply the operation. What are the operation you have to apply? You have to apply selection, the LT sum operation, that is keeping the best individual, then followed by you have to apply what is that operation? Selection operation. So what is he here? So this first is the only original population and its corresponding fitness value. Then selection operation is applied. What is the objective of selection operation? Keeping the good individual more copies and deleting the more individual, worst individuals. So here, what is the good individual? Yes, 0.6047 is the one which is giving maximum fitness value. That is the more best individual. And whose corresponding x and y value are 4.6817 and 6.2593. See here. This value is having more copies. That means wherever some worst values are there, in that place, the good copies are copied. That is overwritten, meaning that the principle of survival of fittest is produced. That means this 0.6047 produced by X and Y, 4.6817 and 6.2593, is the only individual which survive in the given environment and which dominate the other variable value, which is not producing the good fitness value. So it dominate means it is overwriting those values so that we are getting more copies of the individual in the subsequent operation. What is the subsequent operation? It is crossover. You are selecting the two individual and some kind of crossover operation is performed. Say for example, where the crossover operation C 4.687 and 6.2593 has been crossed 4.6817, 6.25, and it been taken with these two variable and some kind of cross, that is simply swapping the operation, and the result of the crossover operation is given in the final slide. I will give you a complete matrix where we can find the entire change of the value. So after this crossover operation, then you need to do a mutation operation, that is sudden change of the value, then followed by, see, this LT sum operation, either you have to do it in the first stage itself, that is keeping the best two individual and keeping it separately. So this complete slide explain the various process, initial population, its fitness value, then population after generation one. That is after generation one means after LT sum, selection, crossover and mutation. It is found that the value is getting little increased from 0.6047 to 0.8439. It means that so the effect of the genetic operation have some impact on producing the still better value. So what you can do here also, you have to check whether you have to stop the process or not. If you want, you can stop the process by returning the value of 0.8439 as the best value, whose x and y value are this. If not, you have to still go further by applying the operation repeatedly. So this is the complete graph showing the value. See, initial population, fitness value, population after selection, population after crossover, population after mutation, after elitism. That is, elitism, best two individual is taken, then it is overwritten. So after this, this is the next population. Look at it. Initial population 4.7987, 6.9861. How it is generated? It is generated randomly. Look at the corresponding population at the next iteration, 4.6817, 6.2593. How it is done? Maybe it is come because of these various operation in between the initial and the next population. So now if you look at it, the fitness value of the initial population is this, and the fitness value of the population after first iteration is this. So since there is an increase in fitness value, then what you do is you can keep on increasing the number of operations, you can keep on doing the operations repeatedly until it gets saturated. At that point of saturated stage, you need to report the result. If you look at the graph, see, it starts with some kind of generation, zeroth generation, zero value at this generation. Then it is keep on updating by themselves up to some kind of thing called, up to 200 generation, the value is getting updated little by little. There is a vast increase of fitness value. Maybe around 70 generation, there is a vast updation of fitness value because of the operation. But there is a gradual increasing between 80 to 200 iteration. Then after 220 iteration, there is no improvement. So I verified whether there is an improvement there for a period of 50 generation. Then it is found that no more improvement. So I have to report the final value. So the reported values are x equal to 2.0120, y equal to 6.0021, and for which f of x, y is 964.1935 is the ideal, is the optimal value for the given objective function for the RGA. Next, the same case study for particle swarm optimization. Same problem, x1 square plus x2 minus whole square plus x1 plus x2 whole, x2 square minus 1 whole square. So sorry, the range here is not 0 to 6. It is the same range. There is a mistake in the range. It is 2 to 5 for x1 variable and 6 to 9 for the x2 variable. So accordingly, you have to generate the position. That is initial particle position. Initial particle is generated here. So initially, the particle is generated. So what is meaning by particle now? So in nature, the particle may be of, bird. Particle may be of bird or any group of animals or group of insects. So here, particle is the random number generated for x1 between 0 and 1. Then what is position in terms of nature? The bird flying point. Now the bird, where is the bird? At what position it is flying, that is the position. But what is here? It is the actual value of the particle. So sorry, here there is a confusion. It is not generated between 0 to 6. It should be generated between 6 to 9 for x2 variable and 2 to 5 for x1 variable. For each position, what you have to do is you have to generate a velocity. So here is the number for velocity. Velocity is nothing but half of the position. That is, if you generate the position for the variable x1 in the range 0 to 6 and for x2 in the range 0 to 6, then for the variable velocity for each case x1, x2, it is half. That is, if it is 0 to 6 for x1, then it is 0 to 3 for x1 velocity. If it is 0 to 6 for position for x2, then it is 0 to 3 for the velocity x2. So now what is velocity here? Velocity is nothing but another number that is used to update the value of initially generated position value through this algorithm. So now what you generated? So you generated position as well as you generated velocity. So what is position? Position is the actual possible value for the variable x1 and x2. What do you have to do after that? You have to do fitness evaluation task. So what is fitness evaluation task? You have to substitute the value of the variable into the objective function given, then you have to produce the f of x value for each x1 and x2 combination. See, this is initial position, this is initial velocity. For initial position and initial velocity, what you have did, you have just substituted the value, not the velocity value, only the position value, then you have calculated the fitness function. So here you find that 0.230, 2390 is might be the maximum fitness value for the given scenario. So next, what you have to do, if you are satisfied with this 0.2390 value, then you have to stop the process and you have to report the corresponding x1 and x2 value as the optimal value for the x1 and x2. If you are not satisfied with this value and if you want to still do the optimization process, so what you have to do next after that, after the initial iteration, then you have to go into the operation. What are the operation in the PSO? Velocity and position operation. So for which, what you have to do? You have to calculate the individual best value for each case, then for each position, for individual best value for each position, then you have to report the overall best value. From the individual best value and overall best value, with the help of the velocity equation, you have to update the initial velocity. See how the initial velocity is updated after generation with the help of the formula, velocity adaptation formula. To update the velocity formula, what you have to need, what you need, new velocity equal to, remember in the morning presentation, new velocity is equal to weight into old velocity plus C1 into rand of some function with respect to the individual best with the corresponding value plus C2 into rand of some individual value with respect to the overall best value. In that of equation is applied to generate the new velocity from the initial velocity. For after the velocity is generated, then new position is generated. How the new position is generated? New position is generated like old position equal to new position plus change in velocity. With the help of that, you are generating the new position. Once the new position is generated, what you have to do? You have to calculate the fitness value. After calculating the fitness value, what you have to check? You have to check whether any maximum fitness value is there with respect to the previous generation. In the previous generation, the maximum fitness value is 0.2390. But in this generation, the maximum fitness value is 0.2620. What does it signifies? That means some kind of improvement is there in the fitness value when compared with the previous iteration to the current iteration. That means if you are satisfied with this value, then you can stop the process by reporting 2.7027 and 2.2804 as a value for x1 and x2. Otherwise, you have to repeat the process of velocity and position updation for your number of generation so that you will obtain the final optimal value for the problem, objective statement given to solve. So that is the scenario explained here. That is fitness in the original case and the fitness of the iteration. It has been showing some improvement in the generation by generation. And this is the convergence curve. See, until 10th iteration, it has been showing some improvements. That is 0 to 10, it is having some gradual improvements and updation. And after 10th iteration, it is showing no further improvement and is getting saturated, meaning that your variable is getting to the optimal point. After that, there is no improvement. At that point, you have to stop the process returning the value for x1 and x2. That means x and y. For x, it is 2. And for y, it is 6. And the final optimal value for a given objective function is 962. So this is the way you can understood the way of PSO operation with respect to any objective function. So let me stop this presentation for a while and we'll go to MATLAB for demo. So already I loaded all the inbuilt function, all the functions available. See, yesterday I told that for all the cases you can go for toolbox. Likewise, here also you can find a toolbox. See, when you go to the app, you can find a button here, optimization. So this toolbox will make you to solve optimization algorithm. So what you can do is, if you click that, sorry, stop. I can go and do that. Where is that? Yes. If you open the toolbox, see, can I see the tool? Can you see the toolbox window? You see, if you hear solver, here you can find enormous number of objective algorithms available. See, look, see all these, all those objective, sorry, algorithms or mathematical algorithms. You can find some kind of mathematical optimization techniques like integer programming method, quadratic programming method, linear programming method. So many methods are available. There are very few function are going to be genetic algorithm based methods. See, genetic algorithm here and genetic multi-objective optimization using genetic algorithm. So these are the some bio-inspired optimization algorithm available in the toolbox. But what about the other algorithm like PSO or ACO, ABC, other optimization algorithms? So this standard optimization toolbox doesn't have such algorithm in the toolbox. So if you want, you can go and search in the Google and you can download the toolbox and you can use it for your problem. Otherwise, what you can do is you can write code. So what I am going to give demo here is, I in terms of code only, I am going to give demo. So I'm closing the screen and I'm going to share the MATLAB screen again. Yes, MATLAB. So this is the code, that is genetic algorithm code for binary coded GA. So as usual, CLC clear all is there. So you have to generate the various parameter generation, population size, crossover rate, mutation rate, number of variable, two variables, how many number of bits I am going to use it. See, in the example, I have shown you 10 bits, but here I am going to use only 3 bits. So what is the range 2 to 5 and 6 to 7, 6 to 9. So this is the command used to randomly initialize the population between 0 and 1. Let me comment this line and I will show you how the population is generated. Comment. So I will show you where is the run. So, yes. So I saved the window, then I am executing it. So look at it in the workspace window. Where is the population? Yeah, population. See here. So 30 crests. Since it is 3 bits used. In the example, 10 bits is given for illustration. How many bits is 3 bits? So 100, this 3 is for x1. And 010, this 3 is for x1. Accordingly, how many number of bits have been generated? 30 population size is generated. See, here also it is generated. So this is binary version. So first you have to generate the binary numbers. Then this, after population generation, you entered into the loop. That loop is accepting all the population. And what is that loop name? What is that? Inbuilt, what is that function, user defined function inside the loop is, so this function eval popu. So the eval popu is accepting all the user defined function. I already told you how to define a function with the help of the what example, vote example. So compute is the function used there in the first day afternoon session. Likewise, you have to create a function eval popu. So eval popu is objective function which accepts all the population and passed to eval each. Eval each is the population which is passing each and every string. From eval each bit to num is there. In the bit to num only, the concept of linear mapping is used to decode the corresponding decimal value. So let me show the value here for which generation one. I think generation is okay. And this FCN value. Oh no, not FCN value. Eval popu population value chip and that thing is named. Okay, eval popu, that's right. Now if I execute the function, now we can get popu, like, yes, here I can make population. Where I can do this to make you to understand where the values have been converted. For each input, yeah, yes, the input one. So input, if I show here is with respect to, maybe I will shrink the population to some number. So generation is one, population maybe some 3. So because if I do 30, the generation it will take more time. So 3, if I execute it, see, look at it. So this is first population, right? This is second population. Let me expand the screen. This is first population, and this is second population, and this is third population, and this first 3 bit belongs to x1, and this 3 bit belongs to x2, If you decode it with the help of linear mapping rule, what you got? 5, x1, 5. And if you decoded this for a second variable, what do you got? 8.14. So remember, this should be in the range 2 to 5. This should be in the range 6 to 9. So accordingly, you have to decode. If you substitute these three value, you got some f of x function value. So how do you got the f of x function value? Econ FCN is the one which is giving the f of x function value. I can take this also. Why not? Yeah. Here I can take. Okay. Here I can take. See here. X1 square p of 1, that means x1 square plus x2 minus 11 p of 2 minus 11 whole square plus p of 1 plus p of 2 whole square minus 7 whole. So here it is written. So for understanding, I will take the semicolon, omit the semicolon here, save the file. Here it is, the fitness value. So that is the reciprocal of the f of x function. So now if I execute the program, now it is giving you more clarity. I am executing the inbuilt function. Sorry, user defined function cannot be executed. You go to the main file, GA. Now if I execute the main file, see here. So what is done? So this three variable have been converted into input 5 and 8.157. This thing is fed into the fcast. That is where fcast, f of x1, that is a given objective function is there. So what is the objective function value? It is 4.625 into 10 to the power 3. What is its corresponding fitness value? It is 1 by F1. So this is the input value. What is the second input? 2.4286. 2.4286, 7.2. What is this? How it is got? It is got from here. 001 is equivalent to 2.4286. Likewise, 011 is equivalent to 7.2857, like this. So for which the F value is this one. That is 2.358 into 10 to the power 3 for the corresponding. Likewise, for all the cases, it is calculated. Finally, what do you see? How many Z value is there? This is one Z value. This is second Z value. This is the third Z value. So these are three Z values are there. From which, what value you have to take? We have to take the minimum Z value. So this is the minimum. That is the last one is the minimum Z value. And that last minimum Z value is produced by a variable and whose value has been taken. So this is the last one value is produced by, and that variable values have been written and a corresponding f of x has been produced. So that way, for 30 number of cases, you have to execute the process. So let me take away all these things, go back to the previous one, uncommented this, and see, put semicolon, not uncommented, put semicolon here. Semicolon here I have to put semicolon, then here evolve papu, nothing is there. So here you have to modify the value. So the what is the generation initially we have? I think 50. So how many population we have? I think 30. So whether I have to comment anything here? Yes, semicolon is there. So here I have to put semicolon. So now if I execute the program, see, for each and every iteration, corresponding fitness value, that is minimum fitness value, is taken and recorded and it is displayed. So it is increasing. At one point of time, there is no improvement. See here, from here, that means after second iteration, there is no improvement. See here, after second iteration, there is no improvement. It is saturated and the final variable is 26 and the value is 962. For the first two iterations, the value is this one. And for the other cases, the values are keeping and the constant one for the given f of x value, meaning that there is no further improvement. That is, you have to stop at that stage. So that means your algorithm reaches the convergence process. So let me go to the second part, that is real coded version. Where is that real coded version? Here it is. Okay. Yes, I think all the files have been closed. Yes, we there. Yes, I will open the real coded version. Open. Please erase the board. Someone is doing disturbances. GA. Yes, GA. Yeah. This is the real coded version. What I can. Yes, thank you. So this is the real coded version. So when compared with the real coded version, what is done here is, so here directly the population generated. This is the statement for population generation. So let me illustrate you with respect to this until this particular statement alone. I will comment it. After I comment it, then I will take the population here. So if I execute this, see, look at it. So what is the population? It is actual number. Instead of binary numbers, the population generated are the actual numbers. Actual numbers. Then this actual number is used and to calculate the fitness value. Let me show you how the fitness value is calculated. Open yes, Yaval. And then go to open Yaval account FCN. Then account FCN. Then you have to open the file. Yes, FCAS. Yes. So here this function is there. If I if I remove the semicolon, you can get it. So now I once again run the function. See, okay, not displayed. So I just save the file. Because value yes, right. So here also I can commit the semicolon, save the file, and save the file. So it's fitness value I can also comment it. Okay, right. Sorry, we have not entered into that. What is that? We have not omitted the comment. So I will keep the generation 1 so that you can understand well. I keep the population as 3. So now if I run, there is some function match. What is this? Put us in here. If I run, So the function I have to make it in the smaller one. What I can do, RGA, I will convert the function name. See, this is a newer version. Newer version doesn't accept the file name to be all in capital letter. I am closing it and I am opening it in the with the respect to small letters after changing into small case. It's not changing. Oh my god, it is not changing. The file name is not changing because it is already opened in the environment. I have to close it and I have to run it again. So that is the idea here. You will get a f of x value for each case, and that each f of x value will be substituted into the objective function. Objective function that is fitness value calculation. Then you need to decide whether the value is ideal with your expectation or not. If it is ideal, then you have to stop the process. Otherwise, you go for the operation. So let me explain the binary genetic operation. See here, the binary genetic operation. This is the code for elitism. Here the code for tournament selection and code for 2-point crossover. And it is the code for mutation. Likewise, for binary real coded operator, the code are here it is, right? Elitism, tournament selection, see, binary code, arithmetic crossover. Yeah, there it is 2-point crossover, here it is arithmetic crossover. So there it is bitwise mutation, here it is a simple uniform mutation is there. So likewise, you have to write the operation, you have to do it. The same process which is doing it for binary coded, real coded, both are same. The difference is the number. There, binary number is used. Here, real number is used. And the operations are differing since the number type is differing. That's the change. Now, I will close the GA part and I will go with, I think, PSO part. Yes, operation. So this is the operation, this is the code for particle swarm optimization. So what is the thing here is, generation, particle size, the control parameters needed for initializing is range 2 to 5 to 3 to 9. P position, this is the generation of position, and this is the generation of velocity. Before that, maximum velocity. So if the position is 2 to 5 means part of that, 2 to 5 part of that, the velocity range and corresponding velocity is generated. For your understanding, let me take this generation 1 and particle size as 3, and I will come into the loop and I will show you the only the process. So what is the process here? Yeah, I want to show you particle, then I want to show you position, how the maximum velocity is initiated and how the velocity is generated. So if I now execute the program, what you can see is, see, look at it. So this is particle, which is generated with the range 0 to 1. Then you have to initiate the position. What is position? It is the possible value for x and y. So possible value for x is 2.38 for the first case, 8.8 for the first case of x and y, 3.38145 for first case of x1 and 7.0 second, like that. So this is the maximum. See, 1.5, 0 to 1.5, here also 1.5. That is half of the velocity, that is position range. So now the velocity is generated. So what are generated now? Position is generated as well as velocity is generated. So two things are generated. Then what is the duty? As explained with the respect to genetic algorithm, the position is used to evaluate the f of x function value. So where the f of x function value is defined, here it is defined. See, x1 square plus x2 minus 11 whole square plus x1 as a function. So just I am omitting it to make you to understand the idea. Eval each, here is the fitness function is calculated. Eval part, nothing is there. Nothing is there, right? So now I will execute it after removing the loop. So I made generation 1. Yeah, yes, I made the generation 1. If I made generation 30 or 500 here, I cannot show you the result. The result will be completely moving. Final result only I can be able to see. That's why I make the generation as 1 in order to illustration purpose. So here eval part, new fitness value, new position is there. Yes, I can run now. See here. So what is coming? See? See position. That is particle. Its corresponding position. Its corresponding maximum velocity, the actual velocity that is generated between the minimum and the maximum velocity. This is the fitness function value. If you want to verify, just substitute 2.3873 and 8.8514 into this f of x function, this function. If you substitute it here, definitely you will get this answer. That what answer? That is 5.417. If you want to check, I can check you the value here. So if you copy this and if you put the value here, then you will get this 5.4493 value. So likewise for this second one, likewise for third one with the help of the velocity. First one, second with the help of the velocity. After having doing this, then what you did, you have to check whether you have reached the saturation point or not. If not, you are not reached the saturation point. So what you have to do is, you have to do the operation. In particle swarm optimization, what are the two operation? So one is velocity updation, another one is position updation. See, this is the formula for velocity updation. See here. So what is this? New velocity, velocity of I comma j equal to weight parameter into the velocity of I comma, that is old velocity, plus C1 into rand of I best value with the corresponding position, plus this component is the cognitive component, that is Bird's individual knowledge. And this component, that is C2 R of I comma g best minus current position, this is Bird's global knowledge, that is overall, that is the social knowledge, it is communicated occurs. So accordingly, you write velocity statement. Once the velocity is being written, then new position is calculated. So how the new position is calculated? New position is equal to the current position, that is position at that time, plus the velocity. If you add velocity to the current position, what it means? With the help of the velocity, the bird moves to a new position. So new position you got. So likewise, you need to do it for all the cases. So after that, what it done? Every time the same velocity updation, position updation is carried out, new value for x and y is found out. For each new x and y value, what is found out? The f of x value is found out. So what is done is every time the best f of x value is checked, if the best f of x value function is reached, then you have to stop the process, or if you have to do the process continuously, at one point of time you find that there is no improvement and it gets saturated, at that point you have to stop the process. So I put semicolon in all the cases. I think now I'm done with the process here. So let me check once again. What is displayed? So T1 or T2, where T1 and T2 is there? T1. So that is for, yes, I have come at T1. This is for checking the time, how much time it is taking. Save it and I will put it. Yes, now it is okay. I think so for one generation it is running. Where is T2 and T3? T2 might be, yes, after the loop. So I think I want to consider the time consumed by the main loop. That's why I'm using that statement. Yes, I think now it is okay. Yeah, yes. Now, if I want to increase the number of generation, I can do it. So 100 generation, 30 population, I will run the program. See, 100 generation and 30 population. The value from here, it is getting updated. At one point of time, there is no updation. Maybe look at the diagram. So maybe here some updation, first initial value of f of x. So little improvement, sorry, more better improvement here. From this point to there, it is getting improved. Then here, the point is improved. After that, see, no improvement. Even your average value also matches with your best value. So that means your algorithm gets saturated. After that, there is no value to found. So the value returned is for x1, 2, and for x2, 6, and the final value is 962. You can go increasing the value. You can go for 1,000 iteration, and you can go for 100 population. You can increase, keep on increasing it. So you can also run the program. So likewise, you can get, see, the curve for that such scenario. So likewise, you can check and you can verify. Still more there is needed to illustrate you. But anyhow, since it is a demonstration, so this I limit the session for understanding the code of a GA. So only thing, the real code of GA doesn't get executed because the file names are all in capital letter. This latest version doesn't accepting it. No problem. If I change it, then it will be working out. Since it is in the module, I couldn't change it. I have to close it. I have to open it. So it is the same with the respect to simple binary coded GA. So I am stopping this MATLAB screen and going to our presentation screen. So I think I come to a part, final part of explaining the MATLAB code and the hand calculation of genetic algorithm particle swarm optimization. If you are having any question, you can ask, please. Yes, ma'am, tell me, Uma Jyoti. You can ask your question.
This is Uma from Hindustan College of Engineering, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Tell me, ma'am.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. You are audible.
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am. You are audible. Sir. You can ask your question.
Okay. Sir, I have listened to your session today. So it is based upon particle swarm optimization. So if related to this, we have many optimization algorithms like ant colony, Harris-Swap optimization, like that. We have a lot of optimization algorithms. So how to find such code to implement this optimization in MATLAB, and where do we find the such sources? Is there any courses available?
Normally, I didn't encourage the student to go and search the code. So what I will ask is write the codes one by one and I come with the code. I will assist them and I will develop the code. Likewise, only we developed a code for all the cases. We didn't use the downloaded code. If you downloaded the code, it will give you some confusion where you have to modify.
Where we have to modify, that will lead a confusion.
So yeah,
what
you can do.
Do we have any tutorials for this, or do we have any link or some?
Ma'am, it is generally a logic that you have to have in your mind. So you understand.
We have to learn this.
Yeah, yes. You understand the process.
By step learning it.
Yes, ma'am. See, if the genetic algorithm code that I have explained to you, it took me hardly 6 months to develop the code. I think
Sir, voice breaking.
So that genetic algorithm code that I have illustrated you, I think for me it is it took 6 months when I did
the
my
voice
master
is breaking
degree.
It is not for me.
What I am trying to convey to you.
Hello?
Is, hello, is it okay?
Hello, sir.
Hello, is it okay, ma'am? Are you hearing? Hello,
sir. Actually, the problem is from madam side only.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Right, it is a bit tough to understand.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. So, what you can
do? So, once you taught us this one video session.
Hello.
Yeah.
So, your side is, ma'am. Do you have? If you want any clarification further, you mail me, ma'am, so that I can answer your query. So if you want the way in which how to develop the code, so it is your practice only. By practice only, you have to develop the code because this kind of course I have developed during my master. So at that time, I used many time to spend in the lab to develop the code. And we have wonderful team also, actually. So after that, I developed only GA and PSO during my master degree. After that, I developed a code for ACO, ABC. I didn't use any downloaded code. Even my first PhD scholar, I have developed a code for water cycle algorithm. So likewise, you can develop code by understanding the logic one by one. So it means that no need to go for developing the code on your own. Just you need to have the habit of writing the code. So whatever may be the language, even if it is Python or R, so you need to develop the habit of writing code. So that is the basic idea here. So do you have any other question?
Participants, any other questions?
I think no hand raised.
No more questions from the participant, sir. Yes, sir. No more questions from the participant, I think so.
So, if that is the case, let me conclude the session. So, thank the organizer as well as thank the participant. For your enthusiastic participant, it will give me Professor Shivarani. Ma'am, ask your question.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am? Hello? Ma'am? Ma'am, I am unmuting your. Yes, ma'am, ask your question.
Could you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, I am hearing you.
Hello. I am in the PS session actually.
Excuse me, ma'am. Voice breaking.
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Could you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am. I'm hearing somehow. I'm hearing somehow the voice.
But it's not clear, right?
Yes.
The PSO, actually. The problem is here, minimization. The minimization we are having is position and velocity. Velocity, when you are taking, you are told that we are taking half of position. What is the actual significance of
ma'am, there are many research problems.
Yes.
There are many research papers dealing with what is the procedure to decide the velocity actually. So there is a problem with the velocity, that is velocity clamping. So there are many strategies. The first primitive strategy is to take the half of the position as velocity. So you can go for many strategies. There are many variants of PSO are available for which you can take the maximum position as a velocity. Other strategies are also there. One thing is bring down the value to zero and then increase the position. Likewise, you can have many ideas, ma'am. I think I will share some of the literature to you, ma'am. Hello.
What's the actual physical significance of that actually? Is it same for all the algorithms?
What one, ma'am?
Yes.
Are you talking about the velocity or something?
I am talking about the actually. So this velocity, what we have to consider, it's so related to the problem.
Yes, ma'am. So it is just a guiding factor. It is just a guiding factor, or it is just a what we can say,
problem.
Yes, ma'am.
Is this relationship between the position and velocity? What could be the relationship? What is the mathematical significance? We are taking half when we are updating. We are entering with the optimization action.
Your voice is breaking, ma'am. I couldn't get you clearly.
Break.
Yes, breaking, ma'am. Breaking.
Is
ma'am.
It so?
Breaking, ma'am. Breaking.
Okay.
Ma'am, later we can.
Talk. We can discuss. Okay.
Yes,
thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
I do not expect you to be a participant of this event because so yes. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. See, participants, whatever the image recognition problem that I explained you in your mid up slide. So she is my senior during my master degree, and she is now professor in Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology. So I really am glad to be a part to see that you are a participant in this event, ma'am. Thank you so much. I will talk to you later, ma'am. So is there any other question? Yes, Anand.
Hello.
Yes, tell me, sir.
Sir, I'm basically from mechanical engineering, sir.
Yes.
I have a doubt, sir.
Yes, chalunga.
To predict a temperature.
Yes.
Which algorithm is better, sir? To optimize and predict a temperature.
First, you work with prediction.
Yes, sir.
For which you go for the neural network or regression model.
Okay, sir.
So then you will look to the model that is used, artificial neural network or regression model. If you want to optimize the parameters, that is, if you want to reduce the complexity of the algorithm, then you can use any optimization algorithms.
Okay, sir. That means
you can see my paper. You can see my paper. There also, I optimized with the help of classification and optimization algorithm. Likewise, you can do some hybrid model with the help of these things.
Okay. Sir, for a material, if we apply heat in a material, you can predict that temperature, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So, Jagan Babu.
Yes, sir. Sir, it's audible for you, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
Sir, good evening, sir. Nice, sir. Very, very informative, sir. Whatever you have delivered so far, all the days.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
I need your general question, sir.
Okay.
What is the difference between the feed-forward neural network and recurrent neural network, sir?
So there is a feedback connection in recurrent neural network. Only the connection. The presence of connection, you have many other stuff followed by the connection. In feed-forward neural network, all connections are in the forward direction. Whereas in feedback neural network, there is a connection which is given back. So I showed this in the slide. There is a connection between the output layer and the hidden layer. That single connection makes you to have different architecture.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, one more thing, sir. Can you share the current situations, the issues are facing in a neural network, sir, so that we can start doing any research on that?
No, I think actually it is very difficult to work on exactly algorithm. Again, okay. You need a team of people who are working in mathematics. So what you can think is, you can think about application. So you think, sir, about some real world application or real world problem for which you can use the existing model or latest model if it is suited to solve the problem. Because those steps are very tedious, you cannot work with that algorithm directly.
Okay.
So you think about the model. So if your problem falls under classification and it is the classification of image, then you can go for CNN. Or if your problem falls under some sequencing, suppose in case of video or audio, you can choose the RNN according to the problem that you have. So like this can go.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So what is
hello
Pramod.
Yeah. Sir, your session was very informative, sir. Excellent session.
Thank you.
And I am Pramod Barampur from Odisha and currently working in Pune.
Okay.
And sir, my question is that in case of fuzzy neural network, which type of algorithm you can apply, sir?
Yeah, the fuzzy neural network is an algorithm. Fuzzy is an algorithm. Neural network is one algorithm. So if you want to hybridize the two, the power of fuzzy as well as the power of neural network will come into picture. Only thing you decide upon the implementation platform. Whether you will go with MATLAB or you will go with some other machine learning packages. So I think it is better you go with MATLAB software for easy understanding, as well as for easy development of the code.
Okay. So that is if any problem will be there, can you help me, sir?
Yeah, really. So you develop on your own. If there is a problem with any kind of stuff, I may be in a position suitably, or if I am in a position to guide you, then I will guide you.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So our last question.
Hello.
Hello. Tell me.
Sir, good evening, sir. I am Srinivasan, sir.
Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
I have one small question, sir. Can I apply for in security, sir, for key generation for this genetic algorithm, sir?
Yeah, yes, sure. You can find lot of papers in it. See, okay. What you do is you have to think about. See, that's why I explained a slide with the help of a problem like a coffee preparation example. So when you look at the statement, you may not think that it is an optimization statement, right? So,
yes,
but
sir,
how to devise the statement in such a way that it is an optimization statement.
Yeah, okay.
So likewise, you look into the article that deals with the cryptography or deals with the application of genetic algorithm over cryptography. I think I saw some papers. So you can find some kind of way in which it is treated as an optimization problem. So look into the area, into the problem, and think about it, how the problem is divided into changed into an optimization problem, then you can do it accordingly.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
So I think we can close this session. So I want to see you all.
Thanks a lot, sir. All the sessions were wonderful, sir. Sessions were wonderful. All the participants really enjoyed these sessions.
Thank you so much, sir.
On behalf of this event, I would like to thank our management through Dr. Madam Vigneshwari, Arun Kumar, our HOD ma'am, Dr. K. Valarmadi, Dean sir, and the principal, motivating us for conducting like this program during the COVID-19 lockdown period. Thank you all. And also thanks. Thank you, Ganesh sir. Thanks for your wonderful sessions. Hope
you,
all the participants enjoyed. And for participants, by tomorrow before noon, you will get the feedback link. By filling that feedback link, you will get the certificate. And also I will share all the PPTs, YouTube links, everything through WhatsApp and mail. Thank you, sir.
Participants, I wish to say one thing. So whatever the things I shared in the past 5 days presentation, all are the knowledge that I gained during my master degree when I did my MS by research. So all credits goes to my supervisor, Dr. D. Devaraj, who is a senior professor and head from the Electrical Engineering Department, Kalasalingam University. So wherever I go, if I receive such kind of appreciation, then I didn't forget my beloved guide. So without him, I didn't come to this stage. So here I am remembering him. So thanks to my supervisor for making to understand all the hard and tough problems in a simpler way, so that I can also explain the problems that I studied, algorithms I studied, to illustrate to any of the interested participants like you guys. So thank you for your patient listening. So this is not the end, this is just a beginning for you. So you take this idea, whatever you heard here in this presentation, to further, the organizer will share you the PPT, as well as the organizer will share you the YouTube URL links, you from which you can listen to the lecture. So this is just a beginning. So I just given a eye-opener session to you for all the cases, but it is you people to take further. So all the best and best wishes for you. So I give special thanks to my sister, like relation, that is Dr. Valarmadi, who is a professor in PSR Engineering College. So he only initiated this process. Actually, he is also one of the our colleague under Dr. Devaraj, like what I say about Dr. Shibarani ma'am. So thank the organizer, that is co-host Dr. Vinod, and Dr. Sendil Ganesh, who is always communicating with me regarding the sessions and other materials. So thank you, and thank you one and all. Thank you so much.